the things I like most, besides flowers, are animals and works of art that touch you in a very special way. So I guess I was extremely lucky to have them both in abundance when I made my second television special, Color Me Barbra. Going to location worked so well on the first show, we decided to do it again. This time we went to the Philadelphia Museum because the art was so extraordinary, so inspirational, it made me want to climb into the paintings. Paintings by Sargent, Renoir, Modigliani. Incredible sculpture and wonderful period rooms to play in. The hitch was we could only tape there from the time the museum closed Saturday at 6 p.m. until it opened its doors on Monday morning, which meant we had 36 hours to get it done. It was in the days when we didn't know we couldn't do it, so we did. We also figured it would be a shame not to do it in color with all those glorious paintings. Now, color was still kind of new then and going through a period of growing pains. In fact, the color cameras we had were never used before. And just as we started taping, two of them decided they had already enjoyed a short but happy life, and kaplum, they just faded away. And you couldn't fix them. There were no spare parts. They were that new. So we had to restage everything and do it with only one camera. But with an extraordinary group of collaborators, we finished bleary-eyed and went back to New York to our studio, which had been transformed into a lovely little circus set with all kinds of animals, tigers, baby elephants, ponies, a few pigs, an anteater, a llama, and some adorable little penguins. Now, penguins are used to cold weather, and television studios are famous for their hot lights. You get the picture? We almost didn't. Well, we finally finished, and the show was eventually shown on the evening of March 30th, 1966. And now, over two decades, two cameras, and I don't know how many penguins later, you've got a chance to see for yourself if it was all worth it. By the way, did I ever show you my sketches?